I'm gonna start off by giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles and the elders, a great millstone. And peace and blessings to the brothers out there doing this work in truth, sincerity, and faith, man. I'm gonna get right into it. This is Deuteronomy 10 and 12. It says, "And now Israel, which Israel is you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, what doth Yahweh, thy power, require of thee?" It's asking a question. Yahweh is the name of the Heavenly Father. Yahweh. He exists. Alright. Says, "What doth the Lord thy God require of thee? Yahweh, thy power, require of thee, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. But to fear Yahweh, thy power." To fear him, man. Alright, let me grab, this is Ecclesiasticus, or the Book of Sirach, 1 and 14. It says, "To fear the Lord is the beginning of wisdom." Alright? You want to walk wisely in this world, man. You should want to. You should want to be wise. You should want to walk wisely, man. Okay? It says, "To fear the Lord is the beginning of wisdom," man. Alright? And the Lord is only dealing with those that dwell with wisdom. That's also, matter of fact, bear with me 1 second. So I think that's in there. Yeah, this is Wisdom of Solomon 7 and 28. It says, "For Yahweh loveth none but him that dwelleth with wisdom." So there you have it. That's plain and simple. Okay, I'm going to go back to Deuteronomy 10 and I start back at the top. "And now Israel, what doth Yahweh thy power require of thee but to fear Yahweh thy power, to walk in all his ways, and to love him, and to serve Yahweh thy power with all thy heart and with all thy soul." You know, amen. The scriptures tell you. Matter of fact, let me grab this. This is St. Matthew 10 and 28. It says, "And fear not them which kill the body," which, you know, your body can get put to death here on this side by man, man. Alright? It says, "But are not able to kill the soul." Man can't do that. Alright? "But rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell." Because hell is a condition that's played out here on earth, man. We're going through hell right now. Alright? And the Heavenly Father can kill your body and your soul right here in hell. Alright? So, yeah, fear the Lord, man, all right? And do what's required of thee. It's not hard to do, man, all right? The bitterness of this thing, man, is being here in hell, man. You doing the right thing to the best of your ability, and everybody around you is going off, all right? Deuteronomy 10 and 13, "To keep the commandments of Yahweh and his statutes, which I command thee this day for thy good," man. He's posing a question. He says, "What do the Lord require of thee? But to keep his law, statutes, and commandments," man, to the best of your ability. All right? "For thy good." For your good, man. Your betterment, man. Following the Levitical laws, the dietary laws. Alright? That's for your good. Being circumspect is for your good, man. You want to just be sleeping this matrix like the rest of these burnt out light bulbs, man? Well, I can't even say that. They ain't never had light, man. They always been the way they are. Everybody's back in their lot, man. So all of these sheep that are being led to the slaughter, these sheeple, these drones, man. Oh, all those that are asleep in the matrix, man. You want to be like that? Nah, man. This is for your good. It says, verse 14, behold, the heaven and the heaven of heavens is Yahweh's, thy power. The earth also with all that therein is. Everything is his, including you. Only the Lord had a delight in thy fathers to love them, and he chose their seed after them. Even you are above all people as it is this day. You Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. We are the apple of his eye, man. And right now, it's just the elect and the one-third, man, because two-thirds of our people is out of there, man. They not going to get right, all right? It says, verse 16, circumcise, therefore, the foreskin of your heart and be no more stiff-necked. Quit being stiff-necked, man. Circumcise your mind, man. You know? Walk in wisdom. Come to the light, Jake. Alright? Verse 17. For Yahweh your power is a power of powers, a Lord of lords, a great power, a mighty and a terrible, which regardeth not persons, nor taketh reward. Alright? And with that, I'm going to say all praises to Yahweh Bashem Yahushua. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and peace and blessings to the elect, man. Shalom.